Hello and welcome to Real to Real. One of the key recipients of funds from the annual Catholic Appeal is the Newman Catholic Center at the University of Massachusetts in Amherst. There, students can keep in touch with their faith life while away at college. And an important part of the outreach work at the Newman Center are the Focus Missionaries, who keep the college students connected to their faith through Bible studies and other activities at the Newman Catholic Center. A few weeks ago, Focus Missionaries and students from various Newman programs gathered virtually for the Seek 21 conference. Carolee McGrath has more.
At the Newman Catholic Center at UMass, you could say people are seeking. They're seeking the love and mercy of Christ. And there, in the middle of a college campus, you can find him at Mass, Eucharistic Adoration, and in the many ministries available for students, including Focus.
Well, Focus Ministry missionaries provide the evangelization, you know, getting out on campus, you know, because they're this kind of the similar age to the college students. And so, therefore, they're able to kind of meet them in their space, you know, whether it's in the dining commons or on campus.
The Focus missionaries, who are college graduates, lead Bible studies at UMass, do mentorship, and recently hosted the Seek 21 conference in early February. The national conference was supposed to be held in St. Louis, but this year, due to the pandemic, colleges across the country took part virtually. John Mullen is a Focus missionary.
So we had Seek, a conference held here that is typically held at a large city throughout the United States, in one large city. And we've had it here at our campus, virtually and also in person. So we've had over 40 students encounter the gospel through great speakers as well as other sacraments.
Springfield Bishop William Byrne was among the speakers for UMass. For the national conference, the lineup included Father Mike Schmitz, who has a popular video series and podcast and is the chaplain at the Newman Center at the University of Minnesota, Duluth. Also on the lineup, Chika Anyanwu, an international Catholic evangelist and author who wrote My Encounter, How I Met Jesus in Prayer. And Sister Miriam James, a former D1 athlete who had a radical conversion and joined the Society of Our Lady of the Most Holy Trinity in 1998. Her story has been featured on EWTN, and she's also a speaker for the Steubenville conferences. Maria Platero is a junior at UMass.
So I thought it was a really beautiful time. I think Focus has a wonderful way of bringing incredible Catholic speakers and communities together, especially in this time when things are really difficult. They allowed for students to have an opportunity to have that community while still being, for me, in my dorm room.
Students also took part in all-night Eucharistic adoration at the Newman Center and in small group discussions.
Only about 20% of American Catholics, and there are 67 million of us, go to church on a regular basis. And that was before COVID hit. What Focus Ministries does is inspire young adults who are no longer being told by their parents that they have to go to church. And in turn, these young adults become on fire for Jesus and their Catholic faith.
I'm on fire because I know who I am. I know that I'm loved by Christ, and from that deep part of my heart, I want to make sure that everyone knows that. I want to make sure that everyone knows their value, the worth.
And every single student that we encounter desires truth, and honestly desires the love and mercy of Christ. So we strive to show that to others as Focus missionaries.
And long after students graduate, the hope is that they remain ambassadors for Christ in a world that's still seeking him. Reporting for Real to Real, I'm Carolee McGrath.
I have a confession to make. I love bread. I love baguettes, English muffins, you name it. As long as it's got bread in the title, I like it. I can't have it if a farmer doesn't plant a seed and grow that to its fullness into wheat. You see, we don't have the good things if we don't sow the seeds. That's the theme of this year's annual Catholic Appeal, sowing the seeds. And you and I have an opportunity to be farmers, to make our 43 ministries that are supported by this effort possible. From the protection of human life to scholarships for kids to Catholic communications, all of these are done through your generosity. We're just getting underway, and I ask you to be generous this year so that we can have the fruit, a bountiful harvest, thanks to the seeds that you sow. Thank you in advance for your generosity. God bless you.